sound suppression water system arm. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. And liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis, the final visit to enhance the vision of Hubble into the deepest grandeur of our universe.
Bypass across the board, Scooter, no action.
Houston now controlling, Atlantis on its way.
That was the sound of a space shuttle. It is blasting off into outer space to the Moon, Mars, and Mercury. What does this mean? It means that the astronauts are leaving Earth. Astronauts are people who travel beyond the Earth's atmosphere or a trainee for spaceflight. I am referring to the Moon, Mars, and Mercury because they are the space objects that astronauts and scientists have been exploring. The Moon was the first discovered, and Mars was their next discovery. Currently, their next goal is getting to Mercury. Many countries have been working on them for quite some time, if you consider working on something for 50 years. These people are some examples of astronauts and scientists we have in the world today. Haven't you ever thought of how it all began? Don't you sometimes think that it is impossible to fly to the Moon? Well, space exploration started from when some scientists wondered if they could get to the Moon, because they wanted to know more about the Moon. Maybe every night they may have looked up and thought what those shiny objects in the sky were. They have been wondering for a long time, and maybe you have too. The space age began on October 4th, 1957. On that day, the Soviet Union launched Sputnik 1, the first artificial satellite to orbit Earth. The first piloted space flight, though, was made on April 12, 1961, when Yuri A. Gagarin, a Soviet cosmonaut, orbited Earth in the spaceship Vostok 1. After that, John F. Kennedy was the president of the USA. He wanted to land men on the Moon while bringing them back safely. So he worked at NASA and launched the first piloted spaceship that actually landed on the Moon. That was the mark on space history of mankind. On board that ship was the famous Neil Armstrong, who was the very first to walk on the Moon. The other two astronauts were Michael Collins and Buzz Aldrin. All three astronauts flew on the Apollo 11 mission. From that point on, the space race started. The main competitors were the USA and Russia, or the Soviet Union. Both countries wanted the fame of reaching the Moon and having actual facts and research on it. They have invented space rovers, space orbiters, space shuttles, and many other spacecrafts. Even though it is not much, they have made and tested many different models that are used in different ways. For example, the rover was sent on Mars to ensure that it is safe before boarding for research. Different models of space shuttles through 50 years are to find if the new models are better, referring to faster and using less resources to make the model. You may think that space is boring, so here are some cool facts about space. Did you know that there are nearly 400 billion stars in each galaxy, and that there are over 100 billion galaxies in the universe? Space is really cool, and there are many other cool facts about space. Such as the sun, composed mostly of helium and hydrogen, which are gases, has a surface temperature of 6,000 degrees Celsius, and that the Earth orbits the sun at 66,700 miles per hour. Did you also know that many objects that are used in your life may have originated from space? Like TV satellites, smoke detectors, the shape of your bicycle wheel, thermal gloves, edible toothpaste, and controller joysticks. Are all the objects invented by astronauts actually in space at the time they had the idea? More objects that are more important that was invented by the research they have done are medical imaging, the vision screening system, ear thermometers, and firefighter equipment. Many of these objects have made many people's lives easier and happier for entertainment or for having a second chance at life. To this day, NASA is the leading space station that creates and builds space inventions. NASA also trains astronauts to go on expeditions in outer space. NASA stands for National Aeronautics Space Administration, formally speaking for the United States of America. At www.nasa.gov, there's a lot of information about space that you can check. I think it is really cool that there have been missions through the Earth's atmosphere and only a handful of people have gotten to go and see the amazing galaxy.
Thank you for watching my video about space exploration, and I hope you enjoyed it.